My gram called it shining on. The Bible calls it having visions, and the scientists call it precognition. But it all comes to the same thing, no matter what you call it.
Seeing the future.
One possible future. Because those things you shine on, they don't always come to pass. That's how it is for me anyway. Now you listen to me. I've had some bad dreams here myself and some bad feelings. And maybe a half a dozen times I've seen things. Not real things, but not nice either.
What were they, Dick?
I don't need to go into details, boy. But once it had to do with those damned head animals, and I saw something in one of the rooms. I want you to promise me that you'll never go in there. That you'll just steer right clear.
Which room?
Never mind.
217,
isn't it? Maybe and maybe not. Just promise me you won't go in.
I promise.
The Overlook's a funny place. Probably not the best place in the world for a kid that's got the shining. But you say your dad needs a job.
He does. He really does.
You'll do all right if you just keep a good head on your shoulders. What that means mostly is remembering that anything you might see here can't hurt you. Do you get that?
Like pictures in a book?
That's right. People with the shining see things like pictures in a book. And sometimes book pictures can be scary.
My dad has a book with Bluebeard in it. And it had a picture in it of a man with a lady's cut-off head. My mom was mad at my dad for reading it to me. The story was okay. I liked it. But the picture gave me nightmares.
But it was just a picture, right?
Just a picture.
Should you see something scary like that here, Doc, just look the other way and count to 10. And when you look back, it'll be gone. Do you get it?
The other way and count to 10.
Good. Ugh.